This is a really awesome slide, which I think goes to show the Fremont factory layout versus Gigafactory Shanghai layout, pace of innovation. Why is Tesla able to build a factory faster, get it up and running faster, have the gross margins and CapEx, or have the gross margins be higher and have the CapEx be less? What is Tesla doing at the factory level? You know, the machine that makes the machine, it's really impressive. So you can see that in the previous Tesla factory, they had stamping, going to welding, going to assembly, or going to paint shop, then going to assembly, or some cars go to this assembly. Like, just a really confusing hodgepodge of a layout because they were occupying this GM and Toyota factory, and it just wasn't designed from scratch from the ground up, and that meant Tesla had a more trickier time building exactly what they wanted, but they learned from this, from Fremont, and have really been able to take it to the next level with Model 3 Shanghai. And if you look at the Shanghai pictures from the outside, you'll notice it looks exactly like this: stamping, welding, paint shop, assembly. It's like a big U, so simple. And you allow the trucks to deploy the parts exactly where they're needed, when they're needed on the supply chain. This is a huge part of why the Model 3 production ramp took so long and sort of had hiccups, and why they had to do the tent, was because they had this extremely complicated underneath the production line conveyor belt system to deliver parts at the certain right time. But if you don't have the exact part at the exact right time, it can mess up the entire production process. And that was happening because it was way too complex, this system of conveyor belts. So they said, screw it, we build the tent. If you look at the tent, it's this U-turn thing, very similar to Gigafactory Shanghai. And so this is a really cool example and layout. I love this slide of just Tesla, what Tesla's doing at the manufacturing level.